the anthropological analysis has backed up his theory that Columbus did not come from Genoa, as history books tell us. And the linguistic studies indicate that he could well have been born in Catalonia.
The linguistic investigations have shown that Catalan is a likely candidate for the native language of Columbus.
Corona de Castilla, tomo posesión de estas tierras y de cuanto en ellas hay.
Thank you. És la primera nit d'una ciutat vençuda. L'ocupació de les tropes borbòniques arriba acompanyada d'una brutal repressió. La vida de molts catalans està en perill. De seguida, les noves autoritats borbòniques expulsen de Catalunya els austriacistes dels altres regnes hispànics, però prohibeixen marxar als catalans. Malgrat tot, molts ho fan clandestinament, arriscant la vida.
explained to me what it meant at the time, this whole idea of Catalan and the relationship to Spain and what that meant to Gaudi and the people.
It's very complex. Catalonia had always felt since the 18th century, where there was a, during the Spanish War of Succession, that they had been dealt a rum card. Catalan had been, as a language, had become of secondary importance. And yet, of course, they felt that that language and the language of their architecture was something that they had, was completely unique and different to the rest of Spain. And they felt that they had were playing second fiddle, that they had been left aside, and that Madrid was where everything happened, and that Barcelona was a kind of subsidiary, kind of out on the periphery. And so they wanted to put their stamp on their new country, and it was Gaudi who, in a sense, visioned that in bricks and mortar. Lots of other architects tried to help him, but he was the key figure because it was far deeper. He was a far greater thinker. He was far more spiritual. He was far more capable of imaging the myths of the time, the St. George and the Dragon, which is the patron saint of Catalonia. To put the whole dragon as a roof is a pretty impressive thing in the middle of a town which had just straight buildings and kind of the houses that we recognize from all over the world.
And this that's what Gaudi did.
And that's what Gaudi did.
Aleshores, el futbol era una vàlvula per expressar sentiments i no és estrany que en plena dictadura, el 14 de juny de 1925, el públic dediqués una escandalosa xiulada a la Marxa Real, interpretada a les Corts amb motiu d'un homenatge a l'Orfeó català en un partit contra el Júpiter. A la mitja part del partit, una banda d'un vaixell britànic ancorat en el port va interpretar la Marxa Real, que va ser rebuda amb una escridassada imponent per part dels 12.000 espectadors que hi havia al camp. Els xiulets i els crits es van convertir en aplaudiments quan van sonar les primeres notes del God Save the King. Gamper i els seus directius van adonar-se que tot plegat els podia costar ben car. No s'equivocaven. El 24 de juny, el general Milans del Bosch va decretar el tancament de les Corts durant 6 mesos i alhora convidava Joan Gamper a sortir del territori espanyol durant un temps. Acusat dels incidents, el president fundador del Barça es va veure sotmès a una dura persecució per part de les autoritats de l'època. El van considerar responsable únic dels fets i el van titllar de separatista. Gamper va dimitir definitivament del seu càrrec de president i es va veure obligat a marxar a Suïssa.
Catalans, interpretant els sentiments del nostre poble, ens acaba de donar el seu sufragi, la fórmula de cultura catalana, un estat integrant de la Federació Ibèrica.
I am a Catalan. Catalonia has been the greatest nation in the world. Catalonia has had the first parliament much before England. Catalonia had the beginning of the United Nations. All the authorities of Catalonia in the 11th century met in a city of France, at that time Catalonia, to speak about peace at the 11th century. Peace in the world. And against wars, the inhumanity of wars, this was Catalonia.
Ciutadans.